my wife was called, and they said that because of the fact that we were black, some of the members of the congregation got upset and decided that no black couple would ever be married at their church. And so as she had informed me, I decided to come home and comfort her.
In all your time in this church, and I know that your wife had been a member there for more than a year, her father, her uncle, also members, in all that time at the church, did you or she ever feel unwelcome?
Ma'am, honestly, I felt at home. I can say that, honestly say that. I felt that I was in the right place serving the Lord with the right people.
Teandria, do you know who complained about your wedding? Do you know any of these people personally?
No, ma'am, I actually do not, but I do know Dr. Stan personally, the pastor of the church, but none of the members.
Were you surprised that the pastor did not stand up to really what amounted to a handful of congregants saying that you shouldn't be married in that church?
Yes, ma'am, I was. I was very devastated. It really hurted me very badly because I had dreams of having my wedding the way I wanted it. And I also dreamed of having it at the church. And unfortunately, it didn't happen. So I was very devastated and in turmoil and just very hurt.
I want you to listen to this reaction from members of your church today in Crystal Springs. Let's take a quick listen.
I'm hoping the church body will address this, but myself personally, I would like to apologize to the Wilsons, to their family and friends, and the entire black community, because this has happened.
These are some great people and a great church, and I mean, I don't see nothing, you know, what they're saying is true, you know. I love these people, and they love me.
We have basically been betrayed. As racist church, we're not. We welcome anybody that wants to come through those doors.
I would say I'm sorry this happened. And would you forgive the people who caused it? Because we're going to try to.
I have to say that I was listening to you say about the congregation and all those people that were sorry. We're God-fearing people. We love Jesus. We are Christians. And my thing, what I would say to those people and to everyone else that's listening to what we're talking about is that why didn't those people stand up in the beginning? If it was such a minority of people, why didn't the majority stand up and say, in God's house, we don't do this? So it's easy to come back now when the news have focused on this and say, secondhand guess what you would have done or what you would have said. But that was a time to say it. The time was the day before we got married. That was the time to step up and be Christ-like.
And we were seeing some pictures of you and your wife there getting married. It was not the church you originally chose. It was the pastor. The pastor did do the ceremony. Do you have any legal recourse here? Is it against the law to deny somebody a wedding ceremony, certainly at a church where they thought they were welcome?
Well, honestly, we can't talk about the legal recourses. I mean, we just can't do that. I just know that morally it was wrong. Christianly, it was completely wrong. And a lot of people can say right now today that they don't understand why we're going after and what we're doing. But what if it was your daughter, your niece, your aunt, your mother? What if it was your husband, your nephew, your cousin? All we wanted to do in the eyes of God was to be man and wife in a church that we thought we felt loved. What was wrong with that?